Hi, I'm here on Stack Overflow, and this person had a question. They were having a problem serializing and deserializing XML. So I wrote a quick little parser for them using XML Mirror. And when I got back from walking my dog, I realized I had made an error when I first posted my solution. So I decided to remake it with a video since I haven't made a video for XML Mirror in a while. So let's go ahead and get started. You see they only have four properties in their objects, so I'll just show you the little solution I built. Here is this form called response library, and I'll open up this project. Give me a second. Okay, and let me get this where you can see a little better. Alright, and here I just have four properties in this object, so this is just, I created this by hand real quick. So now I'm going to go ahead and close that. Now we're going to go ahead and build a parser, and we'll do that in XML Mirror. So XML Mirror is available here. I'll go ahead and do the quick 5-second plug for it. Go to GitHub Data Juggler and go to my repositories. It's actually just XML Mirror, but I'm just trying to show you where it's, of course it's way down here. Haven't messed with this as much as I should. Okay, so here's the URL if you can see that a little better, but that's, you can clone or download XML Mirror. I've already got it installed, so I'm just going to run it as the exe. I've already got the exe built. I am now going to browse for my little XML file that I created for this sample and click start. Now here is the XML file. It uses reflection to build your XML Mirror reflection. Okay, that's how my little squirrel brain works. But here, what you do is, as the instructions say, I'm going to hit F1 here. Anytime the XML file encounters the word response for an XML node, it's going to create actually the full name of response doc.response. Then it'll create a new instance of your response object, which is, I'm going to browse for that now, which is in the response library bin debug, and here is my response library.dll. I only have one class in this DLL. It's called response library.response. By default, it fills in the name responses.parser. I'm going to give it a namespace of response parser test.parsers. I hope I did that right because I already have my little sample form built. And my output folder is going to be, let me browse for that, test parsers. So that's my, oops, already got that built, but just pretend you don't see that already built. We're just building it again. And now you hit view. Now you'll notice the autofill button becomes enabled. I'm going to go ahead and click it. Now, because these names are an exact match, they're not case sensitive, but the spelling is the exact, it was able to auto map these four properties. Had there been any properties, I'm going to just remove this one just to remove status code just to show you. If your XML files do not match exactly like this, then you can just drag and drop and it will fill that in. Now we're just going to hit build parser. So that's pretty simple. Now I'm going to go over to a little test project that I created in my little response parser test. Create another instance of Visual Studio. And here, I'm just going to show you the button click code really quick before, I've got a bug with this control here. It's my control called the label text box browser control, but just ignore it. I've got it fixed when the program starts. And now here's the click event. All you do is you just have string XML, and I browse for that little file before I hit the parse button. And here you create a parser, and here all you say is parser.parse your XML, parse response. And here I just fill in our little properties. So I'm going to go ahead and run the form. I just wanted to show you how simple this is. And we're going to now just browse for the XML file, which I already have the path there, and just hit parse. And there we go. So that's how simple XML Mirror is to use. So hopefully that answered your question. I know you had asked, you had a problem with XML serialization and deserialization. But I used to have problems with it also. That's why I created XML Mirror. So hopefully you enjoy this. All right, thanks for watching.